हॅलो फ्रेंड्स, मायसेल्फ प्रोफेसर राजेंद्र बाबूराव घारसे. करंटली आय एम वर्किंग ॲज ॲन हेड ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजिनिअरिंग डिपार्टमेंट ॲट एन बी नवले सिंहगड कॉलेज ऑफ इंजिनिअरिंग सोलापूर. आय एम हॅविंग टोटल टीचिंग एक्सपिरियन्स ऑफ 9 इयर्स. आय हॅव कम्प्लिटेड एम टेक फ्रॉम इंडियन इन्स्टिट्यूट ऑफ सायन्स बेंगलोर अँड इन द अचिव्हमेंट्स आय हॅव सिक्युअर्ड द ऑल इंडिया 7th रँक इन द गेट एक्झामिनेशन. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द 2 port नेटवर्क्स, राईट? सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल let us discuss what is the port. What is a port, right? So port is a pair of terminals to connect the external elements, right? So in the network theory, we are having a single port network, 2 port networks, as well as we are having the multiple port, that is a 3 port, 4 port, etc. Okay, so port is nothing but a pair of terminals, right? A pair of terminals to connect the external elements. So here we are having a 2 port network. Here we are having a first port and here we are having the second port, right? So this is a pair, one terminal, second terminal. This is also a second pair, that is a 2 terminal, it forms the pair. Okay, and here we are having a network. Okay, so this is a general representation of a 2 port network. Okay, next. So V1 and I1, these are the input port variables, right? Input port variables. V1 is known as a input port voltage, I1 is known as a input port current. Similarly, V2 and I2, these two are the output port variables. V2 is the output port voltage, I2 is the output port current, right? So V1, I1, V2, I2, we are having input port variables and output port variables, right? Now, generally, these port variables, that is V1, I1 and V2, I2, so we are having total 4 port variables. These are represented, any 2 variables can be represented in the form of another 2 variables, right? So depending on that, we are having 4 different parameters in a 2 port network, right? We are having a Z parameter, Y parameter, ABCD parameter and H parameter. Okay, by one we are going to discuss. So let us first discuss about the Z parameter. Z parameter is also known as open circuit impedance parameter. Z parameter, or it is also known as open circuit impedance parameter, open circuit impedance parameter. Z parameters are the parameters which gives the expression for port voltages, that is a V1 and V2, in terms of the port currents, that is a I1 and I2. Okay, so the characteristic equations of the Z parameters are input port voltage, that is a V1, is equal to Z11 I1 plus Z12 I2. Similarly, V2 is equal to Z21 I1 plus Z22 I2. We need to memorize this. Simply, we need to memorize this. So, Z parameter are the parameters which gives the expression for port voltages, that is a V1, V2, in terms of I1, I2. So, these two equations are known as the characteristic equations of the Z parameter. In the matrix form, we can represent as V1, V2 column matrix in terms of the port currents, that is a I1, I2. Okay, so in between these two, we are having a Z parameter matrix. This matrix is known as a Z parameter matrix. Okay, so V1 is equal to, if we take the matrix multiplication, it will become V1 is equal to Z11 I1 plus Z12 I2, V2 is equal to Z21 I1 plus Z22 I2. Okay, so this is the matrix form representation of Z parameters. So one thing is clear, Z parameters gives the expression for V1, V2 in terms of I1, I2. V1 is equal to Z11, I1 plus Z12, I2. V2 is equal to Z21, I1 plus Z22, I2. Okay, now here, yes, as I said, V1, V2, these are the port voltages. I1, I2, these are the port currents. Okay, next. Now we now find Z11. And Z21, right? So suppose in this characteristic equation, if we put I2 is equal to 0, that is this term becomes 0, this term also becomes equal to 0. So once, if the I2 is 0, I2 is 0 means, can we say that it is like a output port is open circuited? output port is open circuited. So when output port is open circuited, at that time I2 will be equal to 0, right? So when I2 is equal to 0, then from equation 1, can we write it as V1 is equal to Z11 I1 plus Z12 into 0, right? So it is like V1 is equal to Z11 into I1. So this implies Z11 is equal to V1 by I1 provided that I2 is equal to 0. V1 by I1 provided that I2 is equal to 0. So here importantly, yes, by open circuiting the output port, by open circuiting the second port, yes, we can get the value of Z11, right? Z11 is a ratio of input port current. So it is a ratio of voltage to current, right? As we know, the ratio of voltage to current is nothing but it is a impedance, right? So what is the unit of the impedance? Definitely it will be a ohm. So the unit of Z11 is ohm, right? Are you getting the point? Next, from equation 2, similarly, when I2 is equal to 0, from equation 2, can we write it as V2 is equal to Z21 into I1 plus Z22 into 0. So that's why it is V2 is equal to Z21 into I1. So this implies Z21 is equal to V2 by I1 provided that I2 is equal to 0. So Z21 is nothing but, yes, it is a ratio of output port voltage to the input port current when output port is open circuited. So again, Z21 is a ratio of voltage to current. So ratio of voltage to current means what? It is a, yes, impedance. So what is the unit of impedance? It is a ohm. So the unit of Z21 is also ohm, unit of Z11 is also ohm. Open circuiting the second port, we can find the value of, by open circuiting the second port, we can find the value of Z11 and Z21. Similarly, if input port is open circuited, then what will happen? I1 will become equal to 0, right? So when I1 is equal to 0, from equation 1, can we write V1 is equal to Z11 into 0 plus Z12 into I2. Right, so it is like V1 is equal to Z12 into I2. So from this, can we write Z12 is equal to V1 by I2 provided that I1 is equal to 0. V1 by I2 provided that I1 is equal to 0. Right, again, it is a ratio of one voltage. It is a ratio of voltage to current. It is a ratio of voltage to current, right? So ratio of voltage to current means it is a impedance. So that's why the unit is ohm, right? Similarly, next, when I1 is equal to 0, so from equation 2, can we write V2 is equal to Z22 into I2, right? Because I1 is 0 means Z21 into I1, it will become 0, right? So it is like V2 is equal to Z22 into I2. So this implies Z22 is equal to V2 by I2 provided that I1 is equal to 0, right? So what is the unit of Z22? Again, it is a ohm. Unit of Z22 is equal to ohm, right? So importantly, the unit of all the z parameters is ohm. Unit of all the z parameters is ohm. Very important, right? So when or by open circuiting the output port, we can find the value of Z11 and Z21. Also by open circuiting the input port, we can find the value of Z12 and Z21. So that's why the another name for the Z parameter is open circuit impedance parameter. Another name for the Z parameter is open circuit impedance parameter. Here, Z parameter or open circuit impedance parameter. Are you getting the point, right? So next, let us discuss one example, right? What we need to memorize the characteristic equation of the Z parameter, right? What is the characteristic equation? V1 is equal to Z11 I1 plus Z12 I2. V2 is equal to Z21 I1 plus Z22 into I2, right? Next, let us discuss one example. Find Z parameters of the two port network shown in figure. Our task is to find the Z parameters of this given network, right? So one thing, whether it is a two port network, yes, this network is having two ports, right? One port and this is a second port, right? Next, input port voltage is given V1. Input port current is I1. Output port voltage is V2. Output port current is I2. Okay, so V1, V2, I1, I2, they have specified, right? Next, be careful, I1 and I2 are the branch currents, okay? Now, so in order to simplify it, again, simply redraw the network, assign the loop currents. I have considered the loop currents as Ix and Iy, okay? Now, by comparing Ix and I1, can we write Ix is equal to I1? Can we write Iy is equal to I2? Yes, because Ix and I1 in this branch, they have given the current is Ix, and in this loop we have considered the current is Ix. They have given the current as I1, we have considered the current as Ix, right? So in this branch, according to them, the current is I1. According to us, the current is Ix. So can we say that Ix and I1 both are same? Similarly, what is Iy? Iy is also equal to I2. Can we apply KVL to the loop? Yes. What is the first step for the KVL? First thing is assign the loop current, which that we have already assigned. Second one is assign the polarity to the voltage across each element, right? So here voltage across each resistor depending on the direction of the current. Current always flows from point of higher potential to the point of lower potential. So in this 2 ohm resistor, the direction of current is from left to right, right? So this should be the plus here. Here it should be minus, right? Similarly, we need to assign the polarity to the voltage across each resistor. Next, apply KVL to the first loop, right? Apply KVL to the first loop. Yes, what is the KVL equation? Plus V1 minus 2 into Ix minus 3 into Ix plus Iy. Be careful. In this branch or in the common 3 ohm resistor, we are having two loop currents. One is a current Ix, which is coming in the downward direction. Second current is Iy, which is in the current Ix is in the downward direction. Also, the second current is Iy. This current is also in the downward direction, right? So in this branch, the current is addition of the two current, that is Ix plus Iy. So it is like plus V1 minus 2 Ix minus 3 into Ix plus Iy is equal to 0, right? So, but Ix is equal to I1. Iy is equal to I2. So can we replace Ix with I1? Yes. So it is plus V1 minus 2 into I1 minus 3 into I1 plus I2 is equal to 0. Next, further, can we simplify it as V1 is equal to 2 I1 plus 3 I1 plus 3 I2, right? So it is like V1 is equal to 5 I1 plus 3 I2. V1 is equal to 5 I1 plus 3 I2. In terms of voltage, representation of voltage V1 in terms of I1 I2, because the characteristic equation of Z parameter is V1 is equal to what? Z11 I1 plus Z12 I2. So that's why we need to write the expression for V1 in terms of I1 and I2. Okay, so this is the first equation. Consider it as equation number 1. Similarly, next, can we apply KVL to the second loop? Yes, we have applied the KVL to the second loop, right? So what is the yes, it is plus V2 minus 1 into I2 minus 3 into Ix plus Iy, right? So it is plus V2 minus 1 into Iy minus 3 into Ix plus Iy is equal to 0, right? Again, replace Iy with I2, replace Ix with I1. So we can write V2 minus I2 minus 3 into I1 plus I2 is equal to 0. Similarly, after shifting these terms to the right hand side, so we can write V2 is equal to this term and V2 is equal to 3 I1 plus 4 I2. Consider it as equation number 2, right? So in the equation 1, we are having the expression for V1 in terms of I1 I2. In the expression, in the equation of second, we are having the expression for V2 in terms of I1 I2, right? So next, compare equation 1 and 2 with the characteristic equation of Z parameter. That is, compare equation 1 with V1 is equal to Z11 I1 plus Z12 I2, and compare 2 with V2 is equal to Z21 I1 plus Z22 I2. So from this, can we write Z11? Yes, V1, compare V1 with Z11 I1. So what is the Z11? Z11 is equal to 5. Z11 is equal to 5. What is the Z12? It is a 3, right? What about the Z21? V2 is equal to Z21 I1 plus Z22 I2. So what is the Z21? 3. And what is the Z22? It is a 4, right? So the final Z parameters of the given two port network is equal to 5 ohm, 3 ohm, 3 ohm and 4 ohm. Are you getting the point? So simply we need to apply the KVL equation to the loops. First thing is assign the loop currents, compare the loop currents with the branch currents, apply KVL to both the loops, right? You will and rearrange the terms in such a way that expression for V1, V2 in terms of I1, I2, right? We need to get. So here Z parameters, okay? So this is about the today we have discussed the simple example of the Z parameters. Right, in my next video we will discuss about some critical examples. Okay, so thank you, thanks for patiently listening.